So taking a screenshot on your iOS device, whether it's an iPad or an iPhone, is pretty simple and straightforward. Yet a lot of people don't know the series of actions you need to do to take it. And things have changed in iOS 11. There's a lot more functionality now. So if your iOS device has a home button, which is true of anything before the iPhone 10, then all you need to do is find either the side switch or on the iPad, it's sometimes in the top right corner, just your sleep-wake button and the home button and press them both at the same time. And that will take a screenshot. So you can see it flashed the screen and then you see the screenshot shrink to the bottom left. And if you wait long enough, it will go away. And this is basically how it's always worked. That screenshot is going to go into your photo library now. And you'll be able to view it there and share it there and do things with it there. What's different now is you get that little pause there where it's at the bottom left corner. And you can do things with it before it actually gets put in your photo library. So let's do it again. And this time I'm going to tap it when it appears at the bottom left. So I'll tap it and now it enlarges and goes into markup mode. So you can see a whole bunch of different controls here. At the bottom you've got all of the standard markup tools that you see throughout iOS 11. So you've got the ability to draw on different colors. You can select things. You have a plus button at the bottom there where you can add text or even a signature. And you can add shapes, arrows, things like that. You also have the ability to crop by grabbing a corner or a side. So you can see those little blue marks there. So I can crop it to something. And you have a share button at the top right. Tap that and now I can share it using AirDrop, I can use messages, I can email, all of that. So if my intention is to actually send the screen grabs to somebody and I don't want it to be added to my photos collection, after all that's for my photos, then I can do that and not have to put it in my library. Because no matter what I do here, whether I mark it up and then share it or crop it or whatever I'm going to do, when I hit the done button at the top left, I get the option to delete it or save it to photos. So if all I wanted to do was send it to somebody or AirDrop it somewhere or something like that, I can now delete it and it never goes to my photos library. Or I could hit save photos and it will go to my photos library with the markup there. Now if your iPhone has a home button, everything works exactly the same way. But the iPhone 10 doesn't have a home button. And of course some future iPhones will not have it either. So how do you do it there? Well, you use that side button again, but instead of the home button you're going to use the up volume. You have to use up volume, not down volume. Press those both at the same time. And now you get it at the bottom left corner. I can tap it and I get the same set of markup tools. I have a share button except that's at the bottom left here instead of the top right. And I can add things to it, do all sorts of things to it. I hit done and I get the ability to save to photos or delete the screenshot as before, so I don't have to have a copy of it with my regular photos in my photos library.